Hello everyone, in this video we are going to talk about problem B from code forces round 668 division 2, and the problem is array cancellation. So I won't just read the problem statement, but I will quickly explain this. So the problem is we have and sum of the array is 0, so and we can choose any index I and j, and we can decrement ai by 1 and increment aj by 1. If I is less than j, then we can do this in cost 0, but if I is not less than j, then it will cost 1 coin. So we have to find minimum number of coins such that we can make array sum equals to 0, all the elements equals to 0. Initially all the elements may or may not be equal to 0. You can see it may contain negative number, positive number or 0, and n can be as large as 10 to the power 5. So we should do it in n log n or order n. So let's see, let's take this example, and sum of this array is 0, but we have to also make every element in this array equals to 0. And in problem we saw that we can choose any I and j, and we can decrement I by 1 and increment j by 1. So and if I is less than j, then the cost is 0. So we can choose these two index, and you can see we can decrement 7 by 1 and increment -6 by 1 with no cost, since I is less than j. And now let's update every element in this array close to 0 with free cost. So this is -5, we cannot update since we have not any positive number. So and now this is 7 and this is -6, so we can update and it will be 0 and it will be 1. And again, this is -4, and we can update -4 using 1 here, so it will be -3 and it will become 0. And now this is 17 and this is -13, and yeah, we can update -13 and it will be 0 and it will be 4, and this is 4. So you can see we have updated the array elements equal to 0 or close to 0 with free cost, and now we have to find minimum cost. So obviously if we convert every element in this array to 0, then that will be minimum cost. So in that this array we will just find sum of negative number and print its absolute, or we can find sum of positive number and we can print this. And now let's see how we can implement that in our code in order n time. So I will initially take sum of positive number equals to 0 and iterate over the array. So whenever I find negative number, then I will update it using this positive number. So this is 0 initially, so I cannot update -5, so it will be -5. And whenever I find a positive number, then I add that to this positive in variable. So and now positive is 7. So and I won't update this, since we can find our answer using any of the negative number or positive number. So this is 7 in here, and but positive number sum is 7, and now -6, we can update it using all sum of positive numbers. So this is 0, but positive number will be 1, and now the number is -4, and we can update that using this positive number. So this will now become -3 and this will be 0. and now I have 17, a positive number. Then I will add 17 to this positive number, and now this is minus 13, but we can update this using 17. So we will update and it will become 0, but this will also become 4. And now we cannot update 4, since, or we can just add 4 to it, and now it will become 8, and it will remain as it is. So you can see only these two numbers are not get updated to 0. So we can find some of these negative numbers and print its absolute as result. So its answer will be 8. So now let's see the code. So this is input part here, from here to here, and I am taking a positive number equals to 0 initially, and if AI is less than 0, that is negative number, then we will check if sum of positive number here and that negative number is greater than 0, then I will update positive number to their sum and make the negative number equals to 0, and else we will update AI equals to AI plus positive, such that if the positive number is 4 but negative number is minus 5, then the minus 5 will become minus 5 plus 4, so it will be AI plus positive number, and positive number will become 0. And else if AI is greater than equals to 0, then I will update positive number to positive number plus AI, and again I will take result equals to 0 and iterate over the array. AI is less than 0, then I will add that absolute of AI to result and will print result. And I think we can also print this positive number as our result. So this is extra code for this solution. So if you don't want to, then you can skip this code, skip this part, and simply print this positive as our result. So this is it for this problem. For any doubt, you can comment down below, and thanks for watching.